your back, bring the water to the source, make the reason fit the course. Take a journey to the east, meet the peace you like to meet. Beg to bow and kiss her feet, and now she wonder why. Your billboards make shapes, you wreck dumps and drain lanes. Make friends, scatter the foes to follow the thoughts you never know. All of these lead the fate, but clean your fate's the only way to make you see the things you see, to make you dress the same. Now we all under the same maybes, we're all under the grand illusion. Well, allow me to carry on. You go to school, get a job, pay bills, make family, count your pennies and save your pay for a funeral day you'll never see. Wait around and watch the clock, the national chaplain, so you gotta tell your kids about the day you nearly hit the road. Leaders, clergy, perfect saints who walk around anonymously, collect the souls of those who sin in Texas, use the walking in, make the punishments fit the crime. All the lies that like to lie, scrutinize the vows and be for the future while they own. Mr. Man, you're on a way down. you go down where the river runs down. You go
keep on moving, get the other side.
do what your Bible say. Sit down in the valley, just a flooded night, sit low to the lowly low. You go keep on moving to the other side, stay.
As soon as you come in by car, it's like you seem to get sucked in. You don't come in, you don't arrive, you get sucked in. And it's like, you land and you like, you walk about. And like, we went up to the monument today. What was the hill called, the way we went? Brandon Hill. What's that monument called?
Cabot Tower.
What?
Cabot Tower.
Cabot Tower. Cabot Tower. That's a fucking strange place, man, up there. Something's going on up there. I don't know what's going on up there, but it's like, it seems to have this kind of like vibe of like that it's like a beacon, what I call it, like a beacon place. A beacon kind of like points is like kind of like where you kind of like light a fire to tell someone who's like 3 or 4 miles down the road or who's at another beacon point that there's something coming or there's something happening, you know, you communicate by light or fire in the night. The beacon would go up and then they kind of do certain signals, but it was a very ancient thing, man. And as soon as I got up there, I said to James and Ben, they were our kind of fellow travellers. We got James the security and Ben's the driver. As soon as we got up there, I said, something's happened up here, something's gone on. Something different about this place, you know? It's not many places you get that feeling, you know? And that was definitely one of them. I mean, Liverpool's based on a series of, seven hills, and they're all beacon points for a reason. I mean, the Romans bypassed Liverpool, it was no good to them. It was just another fucking place, basically. They were more interested in getting up to Scotland and, Welsh mining and the salt mines of Chester. More interested in things like... They weren't really interested in it, but, Bristol just struck me as a place that kind of seemed to kind of gather people, it seemed to suck people in, you know? And I think these beacons kind of seem to be the reason for it, you know?
Cooper stood around in a restaurant talking about a big idea when he was in the corner talking about an LOV, all about this girl and the way she moved, dancing to a table and chair. I look at her as she walks around, baby, she was looking at me. We're talking about an LOV, we're talking about an LOV, we're talking about an LOV, he's talking about an LOV. Sometimes you express yourself when you're talking about an LOV. We're talking about an LOV. We're talking about an LOV. We're talking about an LOV. Just talking about an LOV. Look out, honey. Don't you come back around here again, little boy. Come back around here. back around here again. Don't you come back around here again, little boy. Come back around here. Come back around here. Cafe in Liverpool, and they used to play like fucking to no one, man. You know, it's on Sunday. Used to get all these fucking oddballs, man, to come down and do like spoken word and do like play some songs. This fucking guy playing the didgeridoo at one point. Fuck me. But like. Waitress in there, man, and she's fucking stone dead beautiful. She had like dark hair, man, and brown eyes, you know, that classic kind of waitress look. I don't really like blondes, I like brunettes. And this girl was a brunette, but she told me about this time as Cupid came in. She started giving advice. Just to be wet. Well, this guy came in one day and he seen Cupid standing at the restaurant counter. And he said, "Hey Cupid, you know," he said, "I've got a problem." So Cupid goes, "Oh yeah, tell me about it." So this guy says, "You know, he says, "That's no good, man. What's going on with me?" Hey. Don't you come back around here again, little boy. Come back around here again. Don't you come back around here again, little boy. Come back around here again. Don't you come back around here again, little boy. Back around here again. Don't you come back around here again, little boy. Come back around here. Back around here. Thank you.
Anyway, thank you very much. I'm going to do one more. Like, I want to say, Ben, thanks very much for driving us down here, man. Do you know what I mean? Tom, thanks for having us down here, man. And, whatever. Thanks to the bar staff, you know what I mean? You're a different engineer. Where did you come from? Is that how you work?
You can thank me as well, man.
He's
waiting
here.
I'll thank him
for you.
He doesn't even
know
your fucking
name, man. What's your name? Adam. Adam and Alan. Thank you very much.
No problem.
This is the way they roll down here. They like to change engineers.
He's just the encore, is.
What was he? Fucking hell, you've got expensive tastes now, yeah. Anyway, this one, okay, right, this is my last one. Thanks very much. I don't know, maybe Roy might get up, I don't know, he might tell you, he's got something very, 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 very personal he wants to share with you, and I don't know, I tried to convince him to get up and say, like, could you please kind of, like, say, like, the epilogue of the night and say thank you to people and express what they feel and how he feels, and he might do it, he might not, but if you show him enough love, he might get up and he might tell you this very important fragment. Anyway, this is my last one. This is called Your Love, okay? So thanks very much.
Leave the house without leaving all your rings. That's just your love. Thank you. Good night.